What's up, yo? This is the golfer's take on Trayvon Martin and the Zimmerman goof. And unlike other videos on YouTube, they disabled the comments, so all the racist idiots can't be making their posts. But that's just hiding the bad guys. I'm not gonna do that. I fully expect all the fruitcakes to be writing in. And yeah, I just saw just last night this one soul performer. He did the song for Martin, and then he gets all kinds of abuse and gets I don't know if he got attacked or not, but yeah, it wasn't good. Anyway, just yesterday. Okay, here's the take on some of the people here in this country, Canada. And I'm not even close to where Zimmerman is, and I want to take his hat off. And see, I'm wearing this, and the reason why is, if I'm going to 7-Eleven, I wouldn't be getting Skittles or Arizona. No, I'd be getting French vanilla, because everybody knows I like coffee, and this is it's not Timmy's, but it's good enough. So I'm coming back from 7-Eleven with a French vanilla, and I go do it the same way. And being in Florida, you're gonna probably have a tan somewhat, like I would if I'm there for any length of time. So I'm probably gonna look like let's see, Native American, Hispanic possibly. So I walked to the same area, and he's gonna think I'm a bad guy. Well, see, I just mentioned it to my friend here on Spin Chat. If peeps in this neighborhood think their crime rate's going down, because no, it's going up, and not just everybody's all concerned about the break-ins. You might want to think about the murder rate, because anybody who's walking through there is thinking, okay, am I going to make it home alive? Oh no, I'd be packing heat. I would, and this guy clearly, he was following him around. Some will say, oh no, he attacked him. Well, okay, if you heard the 911 guy say, okay, this is not a good idea to be following him, yet he does. So that's a bad decision. This Zimmerman idiot, if you looked at him in the courtroom, does he not look like a bumbling idiot? To me, he does. And to get your ass kicked by a 17-year-old, what's wrong with this picture? This is what you got for neighborhood watch. Okay. Okay, I'm gonna get into the neighborhood thing too. Cause I saw people talking about the neighborhood. Okay, how bad it is. Okay, this gate's broken here. There's no lights over here. They don't want to spend money on it. Clearly they don't, because they had this goof. They don't want to hire professionals who, you know, aren't going to be chasing them, because their job is observe and report. That's it. Not get out and chase. See what happens? So now all these other guys, all these other people that are making the same way, they're thinking there might be another guy doing the same thing. He's going to get off just like this guy. So you're gonna have to defend yourself. I mean, with a gun. Sadly, that's what you're gonna have to do. And I'd be doing the same thing. And I don't know. Oh, and okay. And like I mentioned, my friend there on Spin there. I mentioned this story. And my buddy Billy, as soon as he sees this, he's gonna have a good laugh about it. And actually, it was kind of funny then. And so when I was like, what was it, about 18, I think it was, and I was living in with my mom over in this bad area over in town, and the apartment building is called Boardwalk. He lived in the one in Longview, and I'm pretty sure he knows where this is going. And so they had the superintendent, not a wannabe cop like this goof, Zimmerman. He walked around with chains, and why you're walking around with like a big chain in your hand is beyond me. Okay, he's thinking, oh, he's a tough guy, and he even yapped at me one time, and I'm not even over there. I'm over in my area, and he goes, and he says, okay, your asshole friend, he's a dick, and he says, don't come over here causing trouble. I'm like, don't worry about it. I'm like, what's the problem? So then he started walking. He was yapping at Billy, I guess, and so Billy said, okay, I had enough of this guy. So he goes down there, and he gets him on the ground, works him over. And so all the neighboring, you know, everybody in the apartment building, they were cheering him and going, oh, awesome. Well, this guy was a real goof doing what he was doing. So, see, that I didn't forget that part, because I'm thinking when Zimmerman was getting into it with Martin, and to me, Zimmerman was being a creep. You don't follow somebody around. You know how many missing kids go missing anywhere, all over America, thousands of them. So this guy following him, I'm thinking, okay, I don't know who this guy is. Could be a child molester, it could be anything. So I'm thinking this wasn't the first time he did that, chasing after someone. And there's probably a whole lot of people in this neighborhood thinking this guy is a dick, just waiting for somebody just to take him out. And well, the time came, and you were just picking on anybody. Oh, and then so he didn't know who he was, right? So yesterday, I go into town. I go talk to this one guy in this one shop. I'm not gonna say who he is, because in case somebody wants to go question him on it. As soon as I say who it is, others are gonna say, oh yeah, okay, yeah, that's the way this guy is. Well, this guy's so off on everything, it's not funny. So I'm talking to him, and I was about ready to leave the shop, and so I brought this up to him, and I knew he was gonna be on board, on the same page. So right away he says, this is a white guy, and he's older than me. He's like probably 60. So he says, it wasn't like, oh yeah, it's too bad about, no. Right away he says, oh, this was a thug. He's talking about Martin. And I'm like, really? I says, do you think Zimmerman knew that? He didn't know that. And I says, and this is why I'm wearing this. I says, what if I wore a hoodie and walked through? Is he painting the same picture for me? I says, as sure as you're standing there, and I go to the same, and I know what's been going on here, I'm packing heat. I'm sorry. I'm not going to that area unless I'm packing heat. I'm sorry. That's just not happening. And here's another one. Here's what a lot of people do. He said he was watching some of the court stuff. I says, I've been watching it too. And I says, Zimmerman got his ass kicked by a 17-year-old? I says, he only weighed 160. And Zimmerman weighs how much? 200. Oh, good call. That's a good wannabe cop right there. How embarrassing. And then he goes, oh, the picture that you saw of Martin, well, that was from when he was like in public school, right? He didn't weigh 160. I says, yes, he did. I said, they had it. I said, if you saw the same court case I did, you had them saying the morgue measured him and weighed him 160, and he was 5'11". He says, oh, did you see the video? He was taller than 5'11". He had shoes on, and he had a hoodie, which made him two inches, maybe three max. He was 5'11". Not, no, 6'3", 6'4". And he weighed 160, no, two, over 200, no. No, they, check it out. So he was just, you know, he had no idea what he was talking about, this guy. I couldn't believe it. And there's lots of people in this country that are just like this guy. Lots like that guy. And like, I want to take Zimmerman's head up, and I'm not even there. And I'm going to Africa pretty soon to see this baby. Oh, baby in here. Oh, I miss you so much. And and my friends who, my friend Jeanette who's there. Hi Jeanette. I'll be seeing you pretty soon. And Simhar, their sister, and everybody else. And her hubby Amon. He lives in Norway. And yeah, it's mind blowing. Okay. Here's like this Zimmerman is like so full of bad decision, and here's another one. This guy, I don't know. My sister said last night he's making an appearance on Oprah. I'm like, you're kidding. Okay, you're doing one of two things, possibly both. You're doing it for the money. Of course, she's going to pay you to be there. Why you'd want to be there? Like, Oprah's, you know, cool and everything. But this is not the kind of stage you want to be on when you got this going on. This does not show good judgment. This is really what it's showing is. You don't care what you just did, and you're going to try to ride the gravy train as much as you can. Really. I suggested to my sister, this guy hop on the plane and get away, like gone, before the civil trial comes. But no, the lawyers are trying to ride this gravy train also. And they're telling him, you might want to sue CNN. You know, that's nice and everything, if you live that long. I'm thinking he's been in hiding for a year. What are you going to possibly do? Between now and they're gonna drag it out. If you're lucky, if Zimmerman's lucky, they settle out, which really I wouldn't, not this kind of case. No, I wouldn't do it. And I don't think he's gonna make it. And I want to take his head off, and I'm not even there. And I'm not related. I think. And no, I know he already had his mind made up, just like that guy that I talked to yesterday. He had his mind made up already. And sadly, there's going to be more of this, and all these other neighborhood watch idiots, wannabe cops, they're going to say, oh, this is a free one, we get to take out anybody we want, and get away with it. Apparently, you know, Zimmerman did. And, oh my. Anyway, yeah. Hopefully there isn't too many more of these, but I know there's going to be. And Zimmerman, I think you're going to be burning in hell, dude.